If you aren't getting the results that you want, you probably aren't putting out the right marketing or generating the right leads. The art of attraction says that we get back what we put out there. This also includes your marketing and lead generation. So what type of marketing are you putting out there? What types of leads are you actually getting? And today we're gonna talk about how marketing and lead generation go hand in hand and how we combine the two using the art of attraction. Hey, before we get into this, don't forget, if you like my content, please don't forget to hit the subscribe button.
Are you wanting a kickstart on your business and you wanna learn how to be the go-to professional in your industry? Well, guess what? I've got a challenge for you. It's 5 days of coaching. It's brand new. Just go to KristaMashore.com/client conversion. That's KristaMashore.com/client conversion. And you'll get a training with me for 5 straight days that's going to help kickstart you as the go-to professional in your industry. So sign up and I'll see you there.
I absolutely love marketing. It's one of my favorite things. Whether you do or not, it's the oxygen that will actually keep your business thriving. Without it, you are DOA'd, dead on arrival. First of all, before you even take the first step in marketing, you need to have your brand defined and know who your target market is. Without these two things in place, you'll be flying all over creation, spending time and money on approaches that have nothing to do with the people that you're trying to actually attract. With your branding, niche, and target market defined, you're going to save money, which we all love, and you're going to reach more people. And you're actually going to get more clients during your conversion phase. You'll know exactly what content to produce, and your marketing message will actually speak directly to your target market. Start by figuring out how much time you'll devote to marketing and what your rough budget will be for this. Most people end up just realizing that marketing takes way more time, way more energy, and way more money, especially at the beginning. Given that this piece will make or break your business, think about how you can actually make marketing a priority in your business. Remember, input equals output. What you're willing to give, spend, determines what you're going to get out of your marketing. So how much time are you actually willing to put into it? How much money are you willing to invest? And what strategy and what system are you going to actually employ to make this work? As I get into this information, don't just sit back and be passive. Use the information that I'm going to be giving you to develop your plan. But before we develop a plan, we need to understand the complete sales cycle. It's a huge concept that most professionals and small businesses overlook, which actually causes 95% of them to fail, or if they survive, they remain stagnant. With these 6 phases of a complete sales cycle, your potential clients or customers end up not only working with you, but staying with you as long-lasting clients forever. The 6 phases of the sales cycle are as follows. Number one is marketing, followed by lead generation, then comes lead nurture, then conversion, and then fulfillment and delivery, and lastly, and most importantly, refer, retain, and resell. Think of it like a romance. And I don't think that most of us are gonna jump into bed with someone after the first get to know you coffee date, right? Well, you might like that guy or gal, but you probably want a little more information and familiarity and trust before you actually take that next leap, right? The first stages of the sales cycle are kinda like dating. You're not forcing the issue for an immediate sale, you're letting them get to know you and to trust you. When I talk about the complete sales cycle, I always recite the 9 C's. You've got to commit to consistently producing content the correct way, very important, and you'll make a connection with people so you're more likely to convert them into clients and customers because of that connection that you've made. When you complete this over and over, you have the complete sales system. Tattoo that on your forehead and don't forget it, read it backwards and forwards all the time and say it in the mirror because this is how you're going to stay busy. I'm known as the digital marketing queen in my area and in my business. That's probably why I know that generating leads is so, so easy. I use the power of the internet. If someone ever tells you that getting good leads is hard, trust me, they're going about it the wrong way. You also may want to utilize more traditional platforms like newspapers or magazine ads and articles, giving personal presentations, networking at community organizations, hosting holiday parties and open houses, or supporting local community or nonprofit schools and those kinds of things. All of these are great lead generating sources. However, if you're utilizing some of those old school strategies that people did 10 years ago, ask yourself 2 questions. Are you getting the results that you actually want from these activities, and are they worth the energy, the time, and the money that you're actually putting into it? And number 2, are you doing that old school activity in a way that is more fresh, innovative, and engaging? The personal connection that you get with some of these old school strategies is great. And honestly, the best overall marketing plans include both in-person and digital marketing strategies. I'm Krista Mashore. Let me know what you think by commenting. And as always, I love to hear from you. So please subscribe to my channel and smash the thumbs up button if you like the content and want to see more of it. And as always, I'm here to serve. Krista Mashore with Krista Mashore Coaching.
Are you wanting a kickstart on your business and you want to learn how to be the go-to professional in your industry? Well, guess what? I've got a challenge for you. It's 5 days of coaching. It's brand new. Just go to KristaMashore.com/client conversion. That's KristaMashore.com/client conversion. And you'll get a training with me for 5 straight days that's going to help kickstart you as the go-to professional in your industry. So sign up and I'll see you there.
The Instagram commenting hack. When it comes to marketing yourself and having a successful business, your relationship with your community is so, so important. In order to be the authority in your community, you need to connect with people first and you need to start building relationships. You need to serve your community, not just sell to it all the time. This is true offline, but it's especially true online. If you're a local business, professional, or entrepreneur, you need to connect with your community offline and on your social media platforms. I want to help you grow your following on Instagram and teach you how to connect with your community through social media. Hi, I'm Krista Mashore here from Krista Mashore Coaching, and today I'm going to be giving you my Instagram commenting hack to actually help you grow your Instagram following. Instagram is global, but it's also very, very local. Many of your favorite local businesses or people are on social media, and it's your job to connect with everyone. Hashtags and searching by location are a great way to connect with your community. My first Instagram hack is to make sure that your hashtags include your local community, the name of it. If you live in Los Angeles, California, or Detroit, Michigan, this strategy is all the same. First, you go to your Instagram, go into the search bar and search with hashtag your city name and hashtag your city name or the service that you provide. All of your posts should include these hashtags with your city's name in it. Then you can expand your hashtags and add another by including what industry you're in. If you're a dentist, you should put hashtag Detroit dentist. If you're a lawyer, put hashtag Detroit lawyer, hashtag Detroit real estate agent. Each Instagram post should have at least 5 hashtags, so mix in some hashtags with your city, and what you do, and then just some general hashtags as well about what you do, what you like, and that kind of thing. Hashtag dentist, hashtag teeth whitening. When you go to search by hashtag on Instagram, it will even show the best hashtags to use. Try not to use the same hashtags for every post, of course. The first part of my comment hack is to use your hashtags involving your local town or service. The second part of my Instagram commenting hack is when you actually comment on local business accounts by searching by location. When you go on Instagram and you click the search page, many people don't realize that you can search by location. You can go in right there, right now, click search, click places, and then you can search for posts from people that are right there in your local area. This is a great way to connect with local businesses and your community. You just search for your town and you see who is posting and what they are posting. Then you start commenting on their posts. If you have any type of assistant or intern, this is a great task for them to do. If you do not have any help, it's still something that is really, really easy, only takes just a few minutes a day, and you can do it while you're waiting in line or just trying to waste time. Make it a habit of searching for posts in your local area in the morning and at night. The best way to gain a following on social media is to build a community and to build with your local community by liking, sharing, and commenting on posts from local businesses and people within the community. This will help you connect with your community virtually. The next step is to connect with them offline. So what strategy are you using and what are you going to try first? Creating posts with local hashtags or commenting on posts from people and businesses in your area? Let me know in the comments below. Again, this is Krista Mashore from Krista Mashore Coaching, and I want to thank you so much for watching this. So why do Instagram stories? Why are stories helpful and why should you start using them as a marketer or as a business? Well, I want you to think about something. Do you want to know what the number one show that is most widely watched by people? It's reality TV shows.
Like, I literally will come at you right now.
Why?
I swear to God.
And here's the deal about Instagram. Instagram is your own personal reality TV show. People tend to go on Instagram under the stories section more than they go on the actual news feed of Instagram. And here's why. Because they can see really quick clips of exactly what it is that you're doing when you're doing it. And this is when on Instagram, on the Instagram stories, you're gonna wanna let them get to know you a little bit more. Think about every reality TV show that you watch. There's lots of action, there's lots of stuff, there's lots of drama. In no way at all am I telling you as a marketer to use a lot of drama on Instagram stories, but what I am telling you is that people like fast, they like speed, they like quickness. They like to be able to go onto your story and see what you're doing right now within the past hour or two. They like to be able to sit down at night before they go to bed and quickly scroll through your day to see all the different things that you were doing throughout the day. So start thinking about utilizing Instagram stories. Now, many people get nervous and they're like, I don't know what to say on there, I don't know what to do. Just talk about what you're doing. Talk about what comes to mind. In the morning when you wake up, what do you think about? While you're getting ready for in the morning for work, or you're getting ready for your day, what kind of things come to mind? You can start talking during that. What do you eat for breakfast and why are you eating that for breakfast? Do you go on a workout in the morning, right? What are the things that you and your family do throughout the day? What are the office meetings that you're having? Who are you meeting with? What conversations and what things are happening when you're meeting with people? You could do an Instagram story, a really quick 15 to 30 second story throughout different segments of your day. Now, I have to admit, I am not the best with Instagram stories as far as making it the time for it, but when I do it, we get such huge engagement from it, so my team really, really tries to help me work on that. So what I would say is, what are you more comfortable with, right? Think about how many different platforms there are out there, and it's really difficult to like be good at all of them, but choose one. If yours is Instagram stories, just start being yourself. Talk about what it is that you're doing, what it is that you're eating, how you're feeling, fun activities that you're doing with, who you're meeting with, the problems and the great things that you encounter throughout the day, the solutions to problems, things that you've learned. Just start talking about it all over your Instagram stories feed. And then occasionally you can post pictures and on your actual feed, but the Instagram stories is where it is at. That's why so many other platforms are actually having their own types of Instagram stories to kind of model that. So, Krista Mashore here. Would love to hear your feedback. Do me a favor, subscribe if you'd like, and let us know what it is that we can do to help you and your business. Hey there, I have a brand new podcast called Fired Up with Krista Mashore, where I bring my high energy right to your ears. This podcast is available on all your favorite podcast platforms. So do me a favor, go subscribe and leave a review. All this information is free and I cannot wait to teach you everything I know. Thanks so much for watching my video. You can learn more about how to be a successful real estate professional by watching other videos that I have. And be sure to subscribe to my channel. And as always, make it a great home selling and buying day.